We are all at the EPO delighted to welcome you for this evening here in this Scuola Grande di San Rocco. So thank you for coming to celebrate an event that is known more and more as the Nobel Prize for Innovation.
I am also proud to have suggested to the city of Venice to host this 2017 edition.
I expect tomorrow that will be a great event as usual, and we will have a lot of suspense about who will be the winners.
The people that are coming here are coming from all around the world, from across disciplines, and they all have something extremely inspiring, inventive to say and present to the world.
It's a wonderful collaboration and networking event, so I'm very, very happy that I'm here.
Sur Science et Vie TV, la remise du prix de l'inventeur européen de l'année, on se retrouve à la fin de la cérémonie. Bonne émission.
Benvenuti in Italia, ladies and gentlemen, a very warm welcome to the 12th European Inventor Award.
Welcome to Venice.
We are here to celebrate the lives and achievements of some inspirational inventors here amongst us.
Here today, we have among us in the arsenal men, and I would add women, of incredible talent. Our economy has been boosted by their inventions. We are delighted that the work of our finalists has captured the public's imagination.
L'inventeur européen du jamais vu.
Padre dei vaccini italiani che ha vinto il premio europeo dei brevetti.
Films about their inventions have been viewed over 2 million times on social media this year, and have been the subject of over 1,000 articles in mainstream and specialist media.
Today we are here for one of the most beautiful competition. Let's say, beside the Oscar, I think this is one of the most exciting ones.
In the category industry, goes to Mr. Jan van Bongaart and Professor Oliver Heider.
Now, what would your advice be to young science students today?
Never give up.
Very good advice.
I do hope that my kids got the idea that if you put a lot of effort into something, you sometimes get something back out of it.
It goes to a team that will make Galileo smile at us tonight.
For the five Galileo waveform sculptures, ladies and gentlemen.
We managed to get something that was good for the citizens of Europe and good for the citizens of the whole world.
Great for the team, great for the program, and also great for European technology.
Please, Mr. Professor Fujimoto, Mr. Swanson, and Professor Huber, join us on stage to accept the award.
You're not surprised after what you've done?
Well, we're very, very happy to be here, and we are extremely grateful to the jury as well as the EPO.
It was an honor and a surprise, and we're very thankful for the award and the recognition.
In the category small and medium-sized enterprises goes to Mr. Huf Schmidt. His representatives have been here today.
When Günther Hufschmidt called you at 11 p.m. to test the material, did you ever think that it could lead to this?
Yes, because he has always very good ideas.
Ladies and gentlemen, the popular prize.
Professor Adnan Hemal.
This award will show to African scientists that we can do, and that also Europe and other regions of the world encourage us to do.
Et puis enfin, l'œuvre d'une vie, c'est la contribution d'un travail en terme, la consécration pour un inventeur, un homme ou une femme, dont le travail a marqué profondément, durablement, la société. Voilà, vous voulez des détails? Regardez.
Axel Ulrich, Rino Rapuoli, Elmar Mock.
Lifetime achievement is not an end, it's a beginning.
Lifetime achievement goes to Dr. Rino Rapuoli.
I really would like to congratulate the European Patent Office, the EPO, because I think it's a very, very important initiative pushing the innovation and this entrepreneurship in Europe.
Being in Italy to receive this award for a work done in Italy is no better combination than this.
We have come to the end of the 2017 European Inventor Award ceremony.